The first thing to do when you receive your PTZOptics Producer Kit is read through the Quick Start Guide. The PTZOptics Producer Kits are available in two varieties, the Standard Producer Kit and the Producer Plus Kit. The Standard Producer Kit can support up to 2 plug-and-play SDI cameras, and the Producer Plus Kit can support up to 4 SDI cameras. The main difference is the use of 2 Magewell SDI capture cards or the Magewell 4-port PCie SDI enclosure box. Note, you can upgrade a Standard Producer Kit in the future by purchasing the PT-PRODUCER-UPGRADE SKU, which includes the 4-port SDI enclosure box. Let's review everything that comes inside the box. Inside your Producer Kit box, you will find a USB keyboard and mouse, a HuddleCamHD joystick controller, a PTZOptics camera, an Intel NUC computer, a Magewell SDI capture card, or a 4-port SDI enclosure with the PTZOptics Producer Plus Kit, a USB 3.0 7-port hub, a Shure MVI XLR to USB interface, a 100-foot plenum rated 3G SDI cable, a 100-foot serial camera control cable, a 6-foot HDMI cable, and a DisplayPort to HDMI adapter. Let's start by setting up your Intel NUC Skull Canyon computer. The Intel NUC i7 Skull Canyon is a powerful micro PC, which includes a 3-year limited warranty. This compact PC is perfect for use with your favorite video mixing software, including OBS, Wirecast, XSplit, or VMix. This super fast micro PC computer comes with Windows 10 Enterprise already installed and ready for setup. Inside, you will find a 6th generation Intel Core 2.6 to 3.5 GHz i7 quad core processor, 32 GB of RAM, and a 256 GB solid state hard drive. Don't let this computer's size fool you. Intel includes a built in Intel Iris Pro Graphics 580 card, which supports up to 3 video outputs and plenty of horsepower for multi-camera video production software. Inside the Intel NUC box, you will find the Intel NUC, an included power supply, a manual, a VESA wall mount with hardware, and an optional black faceplate. Let's go ahead and remove the skull faceplate and replace it with the standard Intel NUC top plate. Once you have optionally changed your faceplate, you can also decide to wall mount your Intel NUC. You can wall mount the included metal VESA plate and screw in the connection hardware to the back of the computer. Once this is done, you can easily slip the Intel NUC into a VESA wall mount slots like so. Let's plug in our Intel NUC computer into a power source with the included power supply. Next, we can connect your computer to one of the available video outputs. The Intel NUC supports a full-size HDMI 2.0 output, a mini DisplayPort, and a DisplayPort 1.2 via USB-C. An example use of all 3 video outputs would include one monitor for your video production software, one monitor for your multi-view, and one for a full screen camera preview, or a 3rd monitor for presentation software like PowerPoint or ProPresenter. Note, the kit includes an HDMI cable and a mini DisplayPort to HDMI adapter. To connect a 3rd monitor, you will need to purchase a USB-C adapter for HDMI. Next, we can plug in the included keyboard and mouse and turn on your computer. Once your computer is on and Windows is running, we highly suggest connecting your computer to the internet via Wi-Fi or a hardwired Ethernet connection. Note, we highly recommend using a minimum of Cat5e Ethernet cabling to provide your computer and or cameras with a full gigabit data connection to your local area network. Now we need to make sure you are connected to the internet so that you can download the applications that you plan on using for video production, presentation, and file sharing. For example, you may want to install OBS for live streaming and video recording, PowerPoint for presentations, and Dropbox for file sharing from remote computers. No matter what live streaming or video production software you choose, the Intel NUC computer should be able to support it. Note, in some advanced video production software, you have to enable your Intel NUC's graphic card for optimal performance. This setting is typically available in the settings menu of your preferred video production software. Note, you may want to download our free PTZ camera applications available at ptzoptics.com/apps. Pro tip, the Intel NUC Skull Canyon includes Intel Turbo Boost 2.0 technology, which accelerates the processor and graphics performance for peak loads, automatically allowing the processor cores to run faster than the rated operating frequency. Your computer should have no problem live streaming and recording with multiple cameras, even using advanced video production workflows. Tip, when you are setting up your Windows PC, we highly suggest using the performance mode and power settings. Also, be aware that using antivirus or malware protection software that runs in the background of Windows will slow down your computer and may cause potential issues. Now, it's time to set up your cameras. As you can see, each PTZOptics camera has the ability to output 3 simultaneous video feeds, including SDI, HDMI, and an IP stream via RTSP or RTMP. The producer kits include 100 foot of high quality plenum rated 3G SDI cabling with locking connectors for reliable latency-free SDI video connections to your camera. You can use HDMI and IP streaming for more video production workflows covered in our camera-specific setup videos available at ptzoptics.com/SDI. You will also see that there are multiple control options for your camera, including RS-232, RS-485, and IP. For the purposes of this video, we will be using SDI for video and RS-232 for camera control. For a flexible two-camera setup, we generally suggest a PTZOptics 12x SDI camera and a PTZOptics 20x SDI camera, since these cameras have different capabilities, such as zoom ranges and field of view, to serve different needs. The PTZOptics 20x SDI camera can be placed on a back wall of your room to zoom in on the presenter, while the PTZOptics 12x SDI camera can be used for other shots, such as an audience or choir, as it provides a wider field of view. The PTZOptics 12x SDI has a 72.5 degree horizontal field of view versus the 20x SDI, which has a 61 degree horizontal field of view. If you require more than two cameras, remember that you just need to select or upgrade to the PTZOptics producer kit. Note, for more advanced information regarding the setup of your PTZOptics camera, please refer to the PTZOptics SDI camera setup video. Plug your camera into an available wall outlet, or optionally, plug your camera into a network switch that can provide PoE, power over Ethernet. Let's put our AAA batteries inside our remote control and test our ability to operate the PTZ cameras. Your remote control can operate up to 4 PTZOptics cameras. You can switch between the cameras you would like to control using the 4 camera select buttons on the top of the IR remote. To set up each camera to respond to these unique buttons, let's turn off one camera and do one at a time, and program each using the IR remote shortcut *#F2. The shortcut allows you to change the button each camera will respond to by using *#, and the function key you would like to utilize to set the camera to that setting on the IR remote. Once your camera is powered on and you have set up your IR remote control, let's plug your camera into the SDI cable to check for video using the included Magewell SDI to USB capture card. The SDI cable will connect to the capture device using the included SDI to mini SDI adapter. The capture card and device will connect to your computer using the included USB 3.0 male-to-male cable. Once the capture card is connected to your computer, you can open up your camera inside OBS or another video production software by adding it as an input. The camera's SDI to HDMI output resolution will be set by the yellow dial switch on the back of the camera. Using this dial, you can select up to 1080p 60 frames per second. You can reference the available frame rates and resolution on the bottom of your camera. Note, do not plug the Magewell capture devices into the included USB 3.0 hub. The USB 3.0 hub is only included for use with non-video devices such as keyboards and mice. Now it's time to set up our joystick controller with the included serial control cables. First, let's set up the HuddleCamHD joystick to power using the included power supply and available outlet. Next, let's connect the included DB9 joystick side to the 8-pin mini DIN camera side cable into your joystick controller. Now connect the 8-pin mini DIN side of this cable into your PTZOptics camera's RS-232 in port. To connect additional cameras to this setup, you will need to use the RS-232 out port of your first camera and connect a cascade control cable to the RS-232 port in on your next camera. In this way, you can daisy chain your joystick's control. Now let's verify that your camera is set up properly. Bring up the OSD of your first camera. You can do this by hitting the menu button on your camera's IR remote control. You can now view the OSD menu on your video feed coming in to your computer via SDI. Make sure that the protocol is set to VISCA, the net mode is set to serial, the V address is on, and the baud rate is 9600. Make sure your V address is set to 1. You will need to repeat this process for each camera in your chain of control, setting each VISCA address to be unique. Tip: you can use the joystick controller to bring up the OSD menu by calling preset 95 on the joystick controller. You can then use the joystick to navigate the menu to use the iris plus and minus buttons to enter inside and out of new menus. Now that we have control of our cameras with the joystick controller, it is time to set up some PTZ presets. To do so, we can drive the camera to specific positions of interest, and once we have the camera at a PTZ preset location that we will want to recall in the future, simply click the set button and the number you'd like to save in this position and press enter. We can repeat this process with over 200 presets until we have saved every location that we desire. Tip: consider keeping a sheet of paper with the legend to record the locations of each camera preset responds to each camera location with your joystick controller. Now that our cameras are fully operational, it is time to bring in our audio. Use the included Shure MVI to plug in the microphone or audio system that you have available. You can connect any XLR or quarter inch audio input to the Shure MVI with the MVI connected to an available USB port on your Intel NUC computer. Once the Shure MVI is fully connected, you can pull this audio source into your video production, much like we did with our camera inputs as a new source. Now that the audio and video inputs are all set up, it's time to make a test video recording the live stream. The Intel NUC Skull Canyon includes a 256GB solid state hard drive, which can store hours of high quality recordings. Once you've selected a recording format and location in your software, go ahead and hit the record button to create a test video. Tip: using OBS or another video production software, you may want to set up a dedicated folder for your saved recordings. Now let's do a test live stream. You can log into your Facebook or YouTube account to set up a test live stream. Copy and paste the stream URL and stream key into OBS or your preferred live streaming software and click save. Finally, you can hit the stream button. You now should see the video and audio stream appearing inside Facebook or YouTube within a few seconds. You have now successfully set up your PTZOptics Producer Kit. Remember that if you have any questions during the setup of your PTZOptics Producer Kit, you can always call the PTZOptics support team at the phone number listed on our website. You can also submit a support ticket at help.ptzoptics.com at any time. Happy streaming!